Do you ever wonder what sustainability really means? Sustainable forestry, green products or green practices, and environmentally friendly are all phrases that are used in conversation on a regular basis. A textbook definition of sustainability is the ability of Earth's various systems, including human cultural systems and economies, to survive and adapt to changing environmental conditions indefinitely. Essentially, sustainability indicates that the relationships and impacts of one thing, whether it's an activity, a species, an ecosystem, to another, has to balance out. For example, crop rotation is considered a sustainable activity, where crop rotation is a successive planting of different crops on the same land to improve soil fertility and to help control insects and diseases. This farming practice is beneficial in several ways, most notably because it's chemical-free or a minimal chemical process. Crop rotation has been proven to maximize the growth potential of land, while also preventing disease and insects in the soil. Not only can this form of development benefit commercial farmers, but it can also aid those who garden at home. Another example is green space. Green spaces include parks and other areas where plants and wildlife are encouraged to thrive. These spaces also offer the public a great opportunity to enjoy outdoor recreation, especially in a dense urban area. According to the UW-Madison Department of Urban and Regional Planning, advantages of green spaces include helping regulate air quality and climate, reducing energy consumption by countering the warming effects of paved surfaces, and recharging groundwater supplies and protecting lakes and streams from polluted runoff. Research conducted in UK by University of Exeter Medical School also found that moving to a greener area could lead to significant and lasting improvements on an individual's mental health. Throughout this course, we will be addressing how humans can be more sustainable in relation to the environment. Our environment consists of all things living and non-living. And when we're considering environmental science, we're looking at how humans interact with those living and non-living parts. There are three goals we will achieve through the looking glass of environmental science: to learn how life on Earth has survived and thrived, to understand how we interact with the environment, and to find ways to deal with environmental problems and live more sustainably, so that we may be in balance indefinitely. A key component of environmental science is ecology. Ecology studies how organisms or living things interact with one another and their environment, where organisms are a member of a certain species and a group of organisms that have a unique set of characteristics that distinguish them from other organisms that can mate and produce fertile offspring. Ecology focuses on ecosystems. An ecosystem is a set of organisms within a defined area that interacts with one another and with their environment of living and non-living matter and energy. Please do not confuse environmental science or ecology with environmentalism. Environmentalism is a social movement dedicated to protecting the Earth's life support system for all life forms. Environmentalism may use scientific basis, but is more of a political or ethical arena. What about sustainability and us, the humans? Life on Earth began about 3.5 million years ago. Since then, it's undergone significant environmental changes. We, humans, as a species, have only been on this planet for about 200 years. Over the last few hundred years, we've begun to take over most of the Earth. In the 3.5 billion years, the Earth was in flux and faced catastrophic changes with various causes, including meteorites, an ice age, long period of warming, which melted the ice and raised sea levels, movement of tectonic plates, moving land masses around, etc. Then along came the human. We may just be one of those catastrophic events if we cannot learn to live sustainably with our environment. Through research of drastic changes and impacts the Earth has undergone, there have been three primary science-based principles or themes to long-term sustainability. These themes are reliance on solar energy, biodiversity, and chemical cycling. The Earth has a dependence on solar energy, which supplies nutrients directly and indirectly. Biodiversity provides ecosystem services and adaptability. In nature, there is no waste. Waste are resources, which brings us to the third theme, which is chemical and nutrient cycling. Sustainability has certain key components that will be used to help describe aspects of sustainability. The first is that life depends on natural capital. Natural capital consists of natural resources and natural or ecosystem services, which keep us and other life forms alive. Our natural resources consist of renewable and non-renewable resources. So let's take a look at what this means. Remember, our natural capital equals natural resources, depicted in blue here, and ecosystem services, depicted in orange. Our natural resources are materials and energy in nature that are essential or useful to humans. We have renewable resources such as air, water, soil, plants, and animals. These resources will continue to exist and or regenerate if not used faster than the resources capable of regenerating. The non-renewable resources are those that are exhaustible. These are resources where there is only a finite quantity on Earth and, once used, will be gone. Non-renewable resources include coal, oil, and metals such as copper. There are also some resources that we consider to be inexhaustible because they will continue to be available no matter how much they are used. Inexhaustible resources include the energy from sun and wind. These resources provide us with ecosystem services, depicted in orange. Ecosystem services are the processes provided by ecosystems that are healthy and support life and human economies with no monetary cost to us. For example, as you can see here, the air provides us with purification, climate control, and UV protection. As well, water provides treatment and purification services. Other services include the renewal of topsoil, nutrient cycling, and pest and population control. Our second component of sustainability is the degradation of those natural resources and ecosystem services, which is our natural capital. Many human activities can degrade natural capital. We often use resources too fast, so that even those renewable resources do not have a chance to sufficiently regenerate before the need or want for the resource arises again. Activities of humans can overload our natural resources with pollution and waste, so that even if an ecosystem service was capable of managing some of that pollution or waste, there's too much and it cannot keep up, or it fails altogether. Can you think of specific examples that humans are degrading our natural capital? What are some things that we can do to slow down this degradation? Of course, we can live sustainably, be in balance with our ecosystem. The third key component of sustainability is that solutions are being found and implemented to correct damages that we have caused, reduce our impact, and to prevent further degradation. However, solutions often involve conflicts and trade-offs. For example, when scientists argue to protect a long undisturbed forest to protect biodiversity, in which a timber company plans to come in and harvest, the timber company is likely to protest. But in dealing with trade-offs or a compromise, the company may be persuaded to harvest in a previously disturbed forest rather than a long undisturbed forest. Additionally, the government may even provide a subsidy or financial support to encourage the timber company to harvest in an undisturbed area and to replant trees in the location afterwards. The shift to sustainable concepts requires a societal shift because ultimately sustainability requires the actions of individuals and communities.